Miss Sharma, my lord.
Good night, my lord.
Can you ever just agree?
You must tell her how you feel.
If you say you feel that feeling.
Feeling? Could you not sleep?
The one that makes it impossible for you to look away from them at any given moment.
You're the bane of my existence.
And now you question my judgment.
Only because you question mine.
The two of you cannot seem to stay away from one another.
Because she is aggravating.
About my dislike for the Viscount.
You hate me. And the object of all my desires.
You were overcome.
Indeed I was not.
You were the one who then looked at
me. You looked at me!
Not in the way that you did.
How exactly did I look?
When all you are able to do in their presence is to fight the urge to lean forward and touch their lips with yours.
Tell me you feel nothing.
Goodbye, my lord.
And I will walk away.
If your silence is an indication you are reconsidering the declaration,
is that what you want for me to reconsider? Do you think that there is a corner of this earth that you could travel to far away to free me from this torment?
It is maddening.
Just not utter what I want.
I do not think that is true.
How much you consume my very being.
My father raised me to act with honor, but that honor is hanging by a thread that grows more precarious with every moment I spend in your presence.
Are the young ladies of London truly so easily won by a pleasing smile and absolutely nothing more?
So you find my smile pleasing?
You're smiling.
Are you going to ask me to dance?
All I find myself thinking about, all I find myself being able to breathe for, is you.
This feeling that plagues us so, it will pass.
Pleasing face, an acceptable wit, obstinate, inflexible.
I find your opinion of yourself entirely too high. It's making me reconsider everything I've ever told myself. One last time.
That's sad.
Michonne,
are you going to say yes? Allow me.
Do not lose her, Anthony.
I love you. I've loved you from the moment we raced each other in that park. I've loved you at every dance. On every walk, every time we've been together and every time we've been apart, you don't have to accept it, you don't have to embrace it, or even allow it.
I do not need you to ask me anything at all.
Kate, you must feel it as I do. I know I am imperfect, and I will humble myself before you because I cannot imagine my life without you. And that is why I wish to marry you.
Why can't I?
You do know there'll never be a day where you do not vex me.
Is that a promise, Cathane Jean?